So I was not into filmmaking. I was a student of engineering actually when I was seeing this film for the first time. And I was in this, I was an IIT student. I was in my hostel room. So this, all the girls hostels, all of us girls, there were six of us. We decided to watch this film. I think it was around 10 or 11 in the night. And we all started watching it. So the way our rooms are structured is we have a, you know, like we have a small room. A table hota, uske pa monitor hota, peeche bistar rehta. And we all sit on the bed and we start watching the film. And I remember halfway around the film, I look around and everybody had left. So one of the girls, like, you know, so people were just not enjoying the film. And I was like, this is the most amazing thing I've ever seen. And I was really not a filmmaking student. Like, I had, of course, I'd watched Matrix and, you know, some Hollywood films. But when I was watching it, I thought it blew my mind because, first of all, it's a film that, like, you know, when you see a film like Matrix, it kind of bends your mind. But, like, you know, this one also breaks your heart at the same time. So it is like it's working at two levels. It's working at your brain level and at your heart level. So that's what I liked a lot about the film. Besides that, what I feel is that, like, you know, sci-fi of this film, like, iske pehle, whatever sci-fi I had seen, Star Wars, anything, it's like so high-tech. And it's talking about generational saga. It's talking about, like, revenge or good versus evil. Here it's talking about just, you know, love and heartbreak. So something that's very familiar to us and also sort of unavoidable. So I like that. So wo ek tha ki, you know, pehli baar maine aise dekha tha, something that was so low-key, but it was also magical at the same time. So I guess that was what struck, like, you know, so yeah. So I felt it was an urban fable in true sense of the word. And dusra, I think so, like, you know, so my introduction to sci-fi has been more or less through Borges or those kind of stories, which are very detailed and deep and, you know, they have a labyrinthine kind of structure. So what I liked about this kind of story was that, like, you know, here, the surrealism that was there, it was something that was intentional also. I mean, they wanted to intentionally disorient. Well, look, they were also playing with us. Michel Gondry and the writer Kaufman, they were throwing puzzles at us. So, you know, the way Jim Carrey was stumbling from one memory to another. So those were the things that, like, you know, so much creativity. And that's like, you know, since then I've been a Michel Gondry fan. So I've seen his work, I've seen his films, but that was the first time I saw it. So I think, yeah, that kind of really blew my mind. So yeah, he, like, you know, he melds his space and time very beautifully. And that is something that I've not seen in many filmmakers. And if you see all his influences, like, you know, so he takes a lot of influences from old magicians and really black and white, you know, real. So if you've seen Eternal Sunshine, this less CGI and this more on camera effects, because he really believes in it. And I think it does have a visceral response. And I think there's one thing that I was like, I learned a lot, like, in future viewing. It's like, if you ever see a science fiction, even if you see Cargo for that matter, there's like a proper set and there's, like, you know, set blocking and this and that. But here it's very organic. And now when I read it, I also about it, I realized that Michel was very clear that it should be treated like a documentary film of a man, you know, going through his memories, trying to save his girlfriend. So in fact, he was very strict about not using too many lights. He was very, so he would say, ke lamp mein extra bulb add karo agar light kam hai to, par upar light mat lagao, ceiling mein light mat lagao, you know, to, and they shot like in real streets of New York, you know, and they had two, three cameras. And even the cameraman didn't know actors kahan jayenge. So he told actors, jahan chalna hai, chalo, it's our job to capture you. So, you know, so I think that kind of treatment to give a sci-fi film a documentary in such an indie style, indie filmmaking style, with also at the same time giving things like car is falling, people are disappearing. So it was just too many brilliant minds coming together. See, if you see the whole film, like, you know, so there are two timelines going in the film. One is that the film happens a day before Valentine's Day, jab usko pata chalta ki she's erased her. And then he goes to the doctor, says, ki erase me, the whole night where he erases, and next morning he meets her. So that's the timeline. And there's a timeline of their relationship, which is across 2 years. And that is in reverse. So basically, we intercut these two timelines. So one is moving forward and niche it's going like this. So I thought it's the screenplay is like a, see, I think when you talk about relationships, you can't say, and memories, both of them actually, both are like, you know, the way you weave in a fabric, it's like that. Everything is so interconnected. And what these guys are trying to do is like weave out one person, like out of it. But you can't just pull it out. Like you have to just go through it, like go here, go here. So that's what it is. And if you see how your memory functions, if you remember someone you love, or if you remember any experience, you remember it in bits and pieces. And that's how this screenplay is written. Like, you know, you go from here. So before, like, you know, we can completely, like, you know, orient ourselves in a new scene, we are cut to next scene. And that's what he has done a lot, like, you know, in the screenplay, which is very beautiful. And I think the screenplay itself has a lot of philosophy. See, Kaufman, anyway, is a god level, you know, he understands philosophy. So there's a, you know, lot of reference to this Nietzschean philosophy, where which says that, like, there are two things which he speaks about multiple times. In fact, he quotes also him. One is that if you want to say yes to any joy in life, you have to say yes to every sorrow that it offers. Like, basically, that's what he says, you know. And that's what he tries to explain through its screenplay, like, you know, many times. Like, you know, this relationship, everything is... See, their personalities are so different that the relationship is incompatible from the word go. But there is still a inherent kind of attraction, which they try to say. Like, the second thing would say that even if, you know, if any relationship ends in a heartbreak, there is, like, what he really, like, the intent of the film is ki even if that happens, there's something very inherently beautiful and sacred about that relationship. So even, and, you know, your relationships make you, so you can't just cut it off, like, you know. So when the doctor says Jim Carrey, he says, like, is it something like, so will I forget her? So he says, you will have a new life. Because it's not just about forgetting a person, it's about reprogramming yourself minus that person. So I think that's what he tries to, like, you know, talk about it. And also, like, the, like, this is something, this is my personal, like, you know, so when I was reading this book, Enchantress of Florence by Salman, so it had a very lovely thing where, you know, so that book talks about Jodha Akbar love story. And he says Jodha is actually imagination of Akbar. So as Jodha, if Akbar goes out for a very long time, Jodha starts disappearing because she's not been remembered. So she craves to be remembered. So it was like, you know, if you see in the screenplay, so these are progression of the relationship. But at some point, Kate, like Clementine, she herself starts participating in saving her own memory. Like, you know, and I thought that was very beautiful. Like, you know, that she wants to stay. So she gives suggestions, open your eyes or go take me to your childhood. And yeah, so I think those were very nice. And in fact, the childhood episode is very beautiful because it makes us see the shortcomings of this, the you know, the seed of shortcomings of this guy. Like, if you see that he couldn't stand up for the bird those kids were trying to kill. So it's not that he cannot stand up for something he is against, but even if he cannot stand up for his own gentle behavior also. So you show that, and he has that feeling that, like, you know, mother is not paying attention. So all that, you know, you see those roots of his personality coming out throughout when his relationship with Kate, like, you know, the way he's insecure when she's come out late, he knows she's not paying attention. So things like that. But so essentially, yeah, I thought those were very nice things. And ek aur cheez mujhe bahut achhi lagi thi, which was, which I was reading about Kaufman, which he said was that there's a very 101 book on psychology, which is like Anarchy, State and Utopia. And they say that, like, you know, if, for example, we all are given a choice, like if we all are suffering through, like, for example, right now we're suffering through a pandemic or whatever, if we are given a choice to get into a virtual machine where we will start dreaming the perfect life, and in that perfect life, we'll not even know that we are in a machine, would you choose such a life? And the answer is that, like, no, because even we cannot, we humans do not want to achieve pleasure and pain at the cost of truth. So I think that's what he says. Like, so the deletion of memory is a reverse of that, that you want to delete a bad memory, but then you are also altering truth. So is it worth it? Like, so that was nice.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this video, and if you like what we do, follow us on our socials and check out our other uploads.